Hello there, this is Max, and today I'm going to show you how the problems are solved. At the left top I have drawn a glass with some water in it and a thermometer, and I will call this one situation 1. Now the question was, what happens to the potential kinetic, thermal and elastic energy when the temperature goes down? So from 100 degrees to 50 degrees. And actually, there is no change in potential energy, since there is no change in height. There is no change in kinetic energy, since the water is not accelerating or decelerating. There is a change in thermal energy, since the water is cooled down. And thermal energy has to do with the temperature. Also, there is no change in elastic energy. Then there was the question about the slide, where the children are playing. I will call the top of the slide situation 2 and the bottom of the slide situation 3. Now the children will slide down, and as they are standing on the top, they do have more potential energy than at the bottom. When they are at the top, they will not have any kinetic energy. When they slide down, they will have, since they are speeding up. At the top, thermal energy has not been produced yet, while at the bottom, thermal energy has been produced, since friction is playing a role here. And elastic energy is not present at all. Then we're going to the top right of your screen, in which you have the two mugs with chocolate in it, and there's exactly the same amount of chocolate, 200 grams, but mug A is 100 degrees, and has a difference with ground level of 25 meters, and mug B is 50 degrees Celsius and has a difference with a ground of 100 meters. The questions now were, which one has the most internal energy? Well, which one is it? It is mug A, since his temperature is higher than mug B. Which one has the most potential energy? Potential energy, remember, had to do with the level of an object compared to the ground. So this time mug B has more potential energy, since its height is higher than that of A. And the third question was, which one has the most total energy? And this one is a bit more difficult, since we have to make some calculations. If you look at the energy balance for these two mugs, you can define them as exactly like the internal energy plus the potential energy. And for the internal energy, I can write the mass times Cp times delta T. And for the potential energy, I can write the mass times the height times gravitational constant. If I now fill this in for A and B, they both have the same mass, they both have the same Cp, only the difference in temperature is different. And for A, this is 80 degrees Celsius, since outside was 20 degrees, and for B, this is 30 degrees Celsius, plus the same mass again. The height is different, 25 meters for A, 100 for B, times the gravitational constant, which is around 10. And then you will see that this one gives something around 80 kilojoules, and this one something around 30 kilojoules. And now you have solved the question. What you should also note is that this term contributes a lot more than this one. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this section.